Thank you. that, and you can get down to Nairobi and be tested again, and the rest will be going to the Rush charity to help in the school and all the needs there. So, thank you.
Well, I couldn't come to that mobile phone's off. If you should have mobile phones off, we can't put them on. Phones off, that's it. Thank you. CD, and it's called Charade. Here we go.
Thank you.
know, we as Christians, we rely on the resurrection of Jesus because it's as Paul says, without the resurrection, we're just pathetic. We've got nothing to sell if we can't partake in the new life that Jesus purchased for us when he rose from the dead. Resurrection.
Lord, we pray for a new vision of your resurrection and a new relationship with you and a new experience of your peace. Lord, we thank you, you've given us the music. And Lord, thank you that you use music to speak to us. Thank you. to. Oh, there we go. Right, praise God. See, what it's all about for us is praising God, and praising God for giving us His Holy Spirit and His presence. That's what we do. And we've done a whole lot of concerts over the years, and God's done some amazing, amazing things. So if you'll bear with me, we're very fortunate tonight, because in these concerts we've got two people who've got wonderful testimonies of what God's done for them at these concerts. So here we go. Shall we go to Helen first? This isn't planned. I don't know what she's going to say. I hope I come out of it with a good light.
Hi. So I'll just give you a little bit of background information. I went to music college, and then I did a postgrad in Switzerland for 2 years. And 3 years ago, just over 3 years ago, I was diagnosed with cancer of the tongue. Sorry if you're squeamish, but I had to have half my tongue removed, and they took flesh from my leg, which is a funny shape now, and reconstructed my tongue, and cut into my neck as well. So it was an 11-hour operation, after which I couldn't speak for about 10 days, so it was very quiet. But so I did believe, I do have faith, and I became a Christian when I was at music college. And I did believe that God spoke to me when I was in the hospital and told me that I would be able to play my bassoon again. But when I was well enough to start trying, I found that actually I couldn't, because the shape of my tongue had changed and it was sitting higher in my mouth and blocking off the airflow to the double reed. So it was quite emotional every time. I would try every 6 months, because they said, you know, things change and you need to keep trying every 6 months, which I did, but I still found that I couldn't play. So in about November last year, I received an email, I think, from our friend here, saying, would you like to play in a concert in Horsham? And I had to respond to him and say, I'm really sorry, but I can't, because I've had this operation and I can't play anymore. He sent a short email saying, be healed in Jesus' name. And I was like, okay. And then after the concert happened, he phoned me and he said, I really felt like God said I should phone you and pray for you over the phone. So I said, yeah, that's great. So he prayed for me. I really had an amazing encounter with God. He was doing a lot of emotional healing in me. So even after we'd finished the conversation and Grenville put down the phone, I was continuing to really powerfully meet with God. Although I didn't feel any healing in my mouth, it definitely felt like an emotional healing that almost felt like a physical healing. And then I received a letter, which I should have got several months before that, to invite me for an appointment to see the specialist dentist at Guy's Hospital, where they were going to do another operation again. Sorry if you're squeamish, but they were going to tether down my tongue and cut off some of the reconstruction to see if that would enable me to play again, which it wasn't something I was really looking forward to. But so I thought, well, I might as well get my bassoon out of my case, because I have to tell them how it is now and I have to see what it's like. I didn't honestly think I'd been healed at all until I got my bassoon out and I could play again, which was just amazing. So it did actually take me a few days before I let Grenville know, because I wanted to really make sure that I could, but I found that I actually had no problem anymore. And even though I don't know what happened, I couldn't play, and then I could play. So then I was able to take my bassoon up to the dentist and play it to them, which was really emotional for all of us, and say, I no longer need the operation. So I'm sitting here for the first time in probably 4 years doing a classical concert. So I'm very happy to be here.
Still involves cancer, but kidney cancer is a silent killer. People don't usually know it until they've got bathroom problems particularly, or they actually collapse and they usually die within a few weeks. That's often the pattern of kidney cancer. And for some bizarre reason, I was one of the fewer than 10% who get a jab in the back of the ribs. I'm a music teacher, so therefore I would have been teaching multiple children in various schools in West Sussex throughout the week. And I would get this pain like someone was screwdrivering me round the back of the ribs here, and it was dramatic and causing me to stop talking or gasp. And I went to the doctor, and he said, "That's okay, well, you know, we might send you for a scan, we'll see." And before I'd even finished my second school that day, he said, "You've got a scan booked at 1:30. So roll on a few years. Post-surgery, several tumours removed, and I was weak. I always lose a lot of blood in surgery. And it was one of those things where you will have that cloud over your head forever if you're not careful and you don't think positively. And this was about 3.5 years, maybe, post-surgery, that I've known Elaine for a long time, violin, and she said Bramble was doing this concert in my town portion, and would I play cello? So I did. And because of kidney problems, it means if I need the loo, I need the loo now, and it really does mean now. I have carry several "please let me jump the queue" toilet cards, which I have still needed, but because of that, in the concert interval, there were a lot of people wanting to, was it before Grenville? I can't remember. It was before, so there were lots of people wanted to go and get changed in the loo. And so somebody sent me to where Grenville had been posted for his little room to pray and get ready for the concert, etc. There was a toilet, and so someone sent me there. So I had to explain, obviously, why I'd appeared outside his little green room, needing to use his toilet. And even before I went in there, he just stuck his hand out, just put it over my head, and said two lines of basically, "Be healed." And he just said it with such confirmation, with such confidence and faith and so on. I was a bit overwhelmed, I think. So I went to the loo and we did the concert, and I didn't think anything else of it. I was very happy that he'd done that. But roll on to the December, and I had my checkup, and that bit of kidney will never grow back. I always will have a kidney function lower than almost everybody in this room. But my kidney function level was higher than they expected it to be. And it was so unusual, they called someone else to look at it, and they said, "You should really only have a kidney function of about 50, which is verging on stage 3 renal disease. It's the same. It's not caused by the same thing, but it's that sort of level. And the average is between 100 and 120. But mine was almost 70, and that's not heard of with somebody with sort of one and a tiny bit of kidney. And I didn't connect the two, first of all. And then somebody at my church said to me, "Well, we've all been praying for you." And I thought, oh yeah, there was somebody else who prayed for me one time. Just two sentences of complete faith. And I started to connect the dots. And the next time I went, I was really well. And one of my friends said to me, "You're kind of more well than you were before." And so, thanks for triggering that. But I really am quite well. So that's pretty good. Thank you, Grandpa.
Just want to add to that. I think it was terminal what you had, wasn't it? And your friend died. It was terminal what you had, and your friend died.
Oh, somebody in my church had the same cancer, but it wasn't discovered till it was too late. And she's been dead a year and a half now. So she lasted 6 years, which is longer than they expected. But here I am, nearly 7 years later. And because, for some reason, I was one of the fewer than 10%, and helped by Grenville having the faith to just say, "Yeah, go with this, God bless you, God heal you, etc."
Well, I've forgotten all about it. I mean, I didn't know. And then at the 2020 last year's concert, Angela came up to me and said, "Hey, do you remember praying for me? Well, I'm healed."
On the stairs, outside the toilet.
I was trying to be polite. "I think I remember you." I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing most of the time. Just praising God. Okay, so praise the Lord. So, I mean, God moves. The whole idea of music, you see, is for God to move. Johann Sebastian Bach wrote in his Bible by the story of David playing and Saul being relieved of the evil spirit. He wrote, "When we praise God with music, God in his mercy appears." And that's sort of been forgotten in the Western church, that music is all about the spirit of God, so we can receive from God. But if you think about the scriptures in the Old Testament, that the prophets would say, "Send me a musician, I want to prophesy." So music definitely releases God's word, and God's word is active and living and changes our lives and heals us. Here we go. We're getting a bit of feedback here. Can we deal with the feedback? This is three pieces, and they're all based on what's called a tetrachord. This is this. Or yeah, just those four notes. Sometimes there's five, and sometimes there's only three. Three pieces.
Thank you. Thank you.
Is that on? Ah, jolly good. Thank you so much. Well, we've reached the cup of tea time, which is always a great achievement. There's tea and cakes outside. But first, I'm going to do my market trading thing. Got these bags, what's inside them. Ah, we've got two of these, healing music, soprano and orchestra. Two of these CDs. Two DVDs of a concert I did for the stuff you've heard in this concert, for Revelation Television, which is a Christian television station. Two DVDs, two sleep DVDs, which is all the scriptures concerning sleep, with me playing really boring piano behind it, so you go to sleep. But don't put this on in the car, because it could be dangerous. So two of those, and solo piano concert there, me for an hour, and another one, Hope in a Dark Place. This is really, I was going through a really tough time, and this is quite emotional. This is very emotional piano playing. So that's all those eight. Oh, and also a good Bible bookmark with my website on it. Two of those. All this, I'm not asking £80 for eight items. I'm not asking £70. Don't you find it boring when a market trader goes on and on about all the prices that he's not asking? I mean, it's stupid, but anyway. So anyway, eight things, CDs, DVDs and everything, £10 for the lot, you see. So if you want the, you know, stocking fillers, Christmas presents, this is an absolute bargain. I mean, I can't even make them for this price. I'm selling them at a loss because I want to get rid of them, you see. So buy as many as you can. And if you want other solo piano CDs as well, you can buy those as well. So I think Jane's on the... Are you going to man the store? That's lovely. Okay, see you at the second half. God bless. Bye.
I'll never get to put together again.
When you say where?
ask you to speak to us now. Thank you that your word went forth and healed Helen and Angela, Lord. And I thank you for all the good things that you want to give to the people here tonight. I thank you that you want to bless them with your Holy Spirit and peace and new life. And you want to forgive their sins and ask them into your So, special thanks, Lorna, on oboe.
Thank you very much for the help.